Hi students, welcome to history class. In the previous class you already studied what are the contributions given by Rajputs in the field of literature, art and architecture and painting. So let's today's class we may study arrival of Turks to India. What are the reasons for arrival of Turks to India? You already studied lack of unity among Rajput kings was the main reason for arrival of Turks to India. So today's class we may learn two famous Turkish rulers like Mahmud Ghazni and Mahmud Ghori and what are the effects of Turkish rule on India. From the beginning of 8th century, there was repeated invasions from the northwestern border of India. Okay, from the beginning of 8th century, there was repeated or continuous attacks from across northwestern border of India. So what are the main aims of these attacks? Okay, first one, looting the wealth of India. Okay, looting the wealth of India. Then conquering territories of India and spreading Islam religion all over India. These are the three main aims of continuous attack from the northwestern border of India. Okay, so who are the first ones to attack on India? Okay, for the first time, Arabs attacked on Indian territories. Okay, when they attacked in the year 712, okay, for the first time, Arabs attacked on Sindh region. Which region? Sindh region in the year 712 CE. Okay, as a result, Sindh and Multan come under the control of Arabs. Okay, both Sindh and Multan, these two places came under the control of Arabs. Okay, so they were successful in spreading Christianity. Okay, Christianity all over India. Sorry, they were successful in spreading Islam all over India. Okay, but they can't continue long period in our country. Okay, their rule was ended in our country. Why? Due to the attacks of Turks. Okay, here Turks ended the rule of Arabs. Okay, Turks ended the rule of Arabs in India. Okay. In this way, rule of Turks started in the history of India. Okay, rule of Turks. Who are Turks? Turks belong to the nomadic tribe of Mongolia, a part of Central Asia. Okay, they belong to nomadic tribe of Mongolia. This is a part of Central Asia. Okay, here Turks were nomadic people. Nomadic people means they don't have permanent place. Okay, they are moving from one place to another place. Okay, they were nomadic tribal people. Okay, then they belong to Mongolia. Okay, nomadic tribe of Mongolia. Okay, here Mongolia, that is a part part of Central Asia. Here, Arthazin. Okay. He founded independent state in the year 963. Okay, Arthazin. He belonged to the family of Mongolia. He founded independent state in the year 1963. Okay, where he founded independent state? Ghazni region of Afghanistan. Okay, here Arthazin established his independent state in the year 1963, where Ghazni region of Afghanistan. In this way, the rule of Turks started in the history of India. Battles between Rajputs and Turks started during the rule of Muhammad Ghazni. Okay, so who was the founder of Ghazni kingdom in Central Asia? Arthazin. I already said Arthazin was the founder of Ghazni kingdom in Central Asia. So after the death of Arthazin, Muhammad Ghazni came to power. Okay, after his death, Muhammad Ghazni ascended the throne in the year 999. Okay, so Muhammad Ghazni, he established huge Turkish empire in Central Asia. Okay, he established very big Turkish empire in Central Asia. Okay, and when he was only 27 years, he earned the title Sultan. Okay, which title he got? Sultan, which means authority or power. Okay, so Muhammad Ghazni was the first Sultan to own this title. Which title? Sultan. Not only this, he was considered as great Islamic hero. Okay, great Islamic hero. Okay, he attacked on India 17 times. How many times? 17 times. Okay, from 1000 to 1027 common era. Okay, he attacked from this timing. Okay, 1000 to 1027 common era, he attacked on India 17 times. How many times? 17 times. Clear this? Okay, so Arthazin was the founder of Ghazni kingdom in Central Asia. After his death, Muhammad Ghazni came to power, or he ascended the throne in the year 999. Okay, when and he established, Muhammad Ghazni established very big empire in India. Okay, at the age of 27 years, Muhammad Ghazni earned the title Sultan. Sultan means authority or power. So he was the first Sultan to earn this title. Okay, then Muhammad Ghazni is considered as great Islamic hero. Okay, he is considered as great Islamic hero. Then he attacked on India 17 times from 1000 to 1027 CE. Okay, these are all the achievements of Muhammad Ghazni. Next, what are the reasons for Muhammad Ghazni's invasion on India? Okay, reasons for Ghaznis, invasion or attacks on India. Why did Muhammad Ghazni try to attack on India? What was his ambition or what was his intention? First one, looting the enormous wealth of India. Okay, what was his first intention? Looting the enormous wealth of India. From ancient times, India was popular for its enormous wealth or more wealth. Okay, so it was naturally attracted by Muhammad Ghazni. Okay, looting the enormous wealth of India. Next, the spread of Islam. Okay, here Muhammad Ghazni was a Muslim, so he want to spread Islam religion all over India. Okay, next, the third one, lack of unity among Rajput kings. Okay, he know very well there is no unity between Rajput kings. Okay, they were fighting each other. So here Muhammad Ghazni make profit from this. Okay, lack of unity among Rajput kings. Okay, then next, to strengthen his kingdom in Central Asia. Okay, he want to strengthen his kingdom in Central Asia. These are all the reasons for Muhammad Ghazni's attacks on India. Why did Muhammad Ghazni attack on India? You must write all these 4 points. First, his main intention is to looting the enormous wealth of India. Okay, second one, spread of Islam. Okay, Muhammad Ghazni was a Muslim ruler. He want to spread Islam religion all over India. Okay, then lack of unity among Rajput kings. Muhammad Ghazni know very well there is no unity between Rajput kings. They are fighting each other. So he attacked on India. Okay, next, to strengthen his kingdom in Central Asia. Okay, Muhammad Ghazni, he established very big empire in Central Asia. So to make this empire become very strong, okay, he made attack on India. Okay, okay, I already said Muhammad Ghazni attacked on India how many times? 17 times. Muhammad Ghazni attacked on India 17 times. Okay, so during the last invasion of India, okay, last invasion of India in 1027, okay, he attacked on famous and rich Somnath temple of Gujarat. Okay, in this year he attacked on rich and famous Somnath temple of Gujarat. Clear this? Okay, this is the last attack of Muhammad Ghazni on India. In the year 1027, he attacked on rich and famous Somnath temple of Gujarat. Okay, so how does this attack was faced by Hindu Rajputs? Okay, Muhammad Ghazni attacked on Somnath temple of Gujarat. All the Rajput kings were shaken by this attack. Okay, but they were failed to face Muhammad Ghazni with the unity. Okay, but also some Hindu Rajputs, they tried to protect temple from the invasion. When enemies try to enter inside the temple, so they could not damage the temple. But after 3 days, Muhammad Ghazni's troops were successful in plundering the Somnath temple. Okay, as a result, Shivalinga was destroyed. Okay, so due to lack of unity between Rajput kings was the main reason for success of Muhammad Ghazni in India. Okay, so what is the result? Okay, what is the result of Muhammad Ghazni's attack on India? First one, Muhammad Ghazni carried enormous gold ornaments and wealth to Ghazni. Okay, Muhammad Ghazni carried enormous gold ornaments and wealth to Ghazni. Okay, next effect, Shivalinga was destroyed. Second effect, Shivalinga was destroyed by Muhammad Ghazni. Shivalinga was destroyed. Okay, so then economic condition of India was fully weakened. Okay, economic condition of India weakened. Clear this? Result of Muhammad Ghazni's attack on India. First one, Muhammad Ghazni carried enormous gold ornaments and wealth to Ghazni. Okay, next, Shivalinga was destroyed. Okay, Shivalinga of Somnath temple destroyed by Muhammad Ghazni. Next, economic condition of India weakened, or financial condition of India fully weakened. What were the reasons for Muhammad Ghazni's success in India? Okay, Muhammad Ghazni got success in his invasions on India. What are the reasons? First one, military and political weakness of Rajputs. Okay, military and political weakness of Rajputs. Okay, second one, lack of unity between Rajput kings. Okay, there is no unity between Rajput kings. Okay, these are all the reasons for, okay, why Muhammad Ghazni got success in his invasions on India. Clear this? Okay, but he did not build his independent kingdom in India. Okay, Muhammad Ghazni attacked on India 17 times and he looted large amount of ornaments, wealth from India. Okay, but he did not build independent kingdom in India. But his attack on India, okay, became a path of future attacks on India. We may learn another Turkish ruler, Muhammad Guri. Muhammad Guri. The rule of Ghazni dynasty came to an end, and rule of Ghori dynasty started in the history of India. Okay, so Ghiyasuddin Muhammad Ghori. Ghiyasuddin Muhammad Ghori ascended the throne of Ghori kingdom of Afghanistan. Okay, Ghiyasuddin Mahmud Ghori came to power to the throne of Ghori kingdom of Afghanistan. Then he sent his brother Mujahideen Mahmud Ghori to start Turkish rule in India. Clear this? Here Ghiyasuddin Mahmud Ghori, he ascended the throne, or he came to the throne of Ghori kingdom of Afghanistan. Later he sent his brother Mujahideen Mahmud Ghori to start Turkish rule in India. He was considered as Mahmud Ghori by historians. Mujahideen Mahmud Ghori as Mahmud Ghori. Okay. Achievements of Mahmud Ghori. First one, he started his first invasion by seizing Multan. Okay. He invaded on Multan. Okay. He made his first attack on Multan. Okay. Second one, he wanted to recapture Sindh province, which was under the control of Mahmud Ghazni. Okay. He wanted to recapture Sindh under the control of Mahmud Ghazni. Next, Mahmud Ghazni attacked on Allahabad of Gujarat. He attacked on Allahabad of Gujarat, but he defeated or failed in this effort. Okay. Later he made attack on Peshawar. And conquered it, captured it. Okay. Then next, Khusro Malik of Lahore surrendered to Mahmud Ghori. Okay, these are all the achievements of Mahmud Ghori. First one, he started his first attack by seizing Multan. Okay, he made attack on Multan. Okay. And he captured Multan to his control. Next, he wanted to recapture Sindh under the control of Mahmud Ghazni. Okay. Sindh province was under the control of Mahmud Ghazni. Okay. Here, Mahmud Ghori wanted to capture this province to his control. Okay. So, he was successful in this effort also. Later, Mahmud Ghori attacked on Allahabad of Gujarat. Okay, but he was defeated. Okay, he made attack on Allahabad of Gujarat. Okay, but he can't get success here. He was defeated. Later, he made attack on Peshawar and conquered Peshawar to his control. Okay, next, Khusro Malik of Lahore surrendered to Mahmud Ghori. Okay, finally what happened? Khusro Malik of Lahore, he surrendered to Muhammad Ghori. He was agreed to give tax to Muhammad Ghori. Okay, in this way, Muhammad Ghori was successful in establishing independent kingdom in India. Okay, Muhammad Ghazni, he didn't build his kingdom in India, but Muhammad Ghori was successful in building independent empire in India. We may learn about one more important achievement of Muhammad Ghori. Okay, what is that? Muhammad Ghori attacked on plains of India. Muhammad Ghori attacked on plains of India. Okay, in this moment, Delhi was ruled by famous Rajput ruler Prithviraj Chauhan. Prithviraj Chauhan. Okay, later what happened? Muhammad Ghori want to capture Delhi to his control. Okay, so in this moment, Delhi was ruled by famous Rajput ruler called Prithviraj Chauhan. Okay, so between Prithviraj Chauhan and Muhammad Ghori, first battle of terrain took place. Okay, between Muhammad Ghori and Prithviraj Chauhan. Okay, first battle of terrain. Which battle? First battle of terrain fought in 1191. Okay, what is the result of this battle? Result: Muhammad Ghori defeated by Prithviraj Chauhan. Muhammad Ghori defeated by Prithviraj Chauhan. Okay, but Prithviraj Chauhan, he didn't kill him. He gave him excuse. So Muhammad Ghori escaped from the battlefield. Okay, clear this. This is the effect of first battle of terrain. Clear this now. When and between whom the first battle of terrain took place? Okay, what is the answer? Between Muhammad Ghori and Prithviraj Chauhan. First battle of terrain took place in 1191. Okay, so what is the result? Muhammad Ghori was defeated by Prithviraj Chauhan. Okay, then next, Muhammad Ghori escaped from battlefield. Next, Muhammad Ghori returned to his Ghor kingdom and he took revenge against Prithviraj Chauhan. He decided to defeat Prithviraj Chauhan. So he made lot of preparations for war. So between Prithviraj Chauhan and Muhammad Ghori, second battle of terrain took place. Okay, between Prithviraj Chauhan and Muhammad Ghori, second battle of terrain took place on the next year, 1192. Okay, so what was the result? Prithviraj Chauhan defeated by Muhammad Ghori. Okay, Clear this. Prithviraj Chauhan defeated by Mahmud Ghori. Okay, next. Prithviraj Chauhan was defeated and killed. Next. Delhi came under the control of Turks. Okay, Delhi came under the control of Turks. These are all the results of second battle of Terai. Okay, between Prithviraj Chauhan and Mahmud Ghori. Second battle of Terai took place in 1192. What was the result? Prithviraj Chauhan defeated by Mahmud Ghori. Next, Prithviraj Chauhan was defeated and killed. Okay, later Delhi came under the control of Turks. Okay, so what was the next? What was the reasons for success of Mahmud Ghori in second battle of Terai? Reasons for success of Mahmud Ghori in second battle of Terai. First reason, archers of Turks were successful in defeating Rajput army. Okay, archers. Okay, those who know the use of bows and arrows, they are called archers. Okay, archers of Turks were successful in defeating the army of Rajputs. Okay, second reason. Here, slow moving, fast moving cavalry of Turks defeated slow moving elephants of Rajputs. You know, cavalry or horses running very fast, faster than elephants. So faster moving cavalry of Turks defeated the slow moving elephants of Rajputs. Govindarao and Bola, who was instrumental during first battle of Terai, died. Okay, here Govindarao and Bola, okay, they were great commanders. Okay, and they brought victory during the first battle of Terai, but at the time of second battle of Terai, both are died. Okay, that's why here Mahmud Ghori got success in the war. Okay, then next, Mahmud Ghori had one of the believable commander called Qutbuddin Aibak. He was instrumental in success of Mahmud Ghori in a second battle of Terai. Okay, Qutbuddin Aibak. Was instrumental in success of Mahmud Ghori in second battle of Terai. In this way, these are all the reasons for success of Mahmud Ghori in second battle of terrain. Okay, understood all this? First one,